1110.
The following program, paid for by Right Path Real Estate, does not necessarily represent the views or opinions.
Just
of
checking, you can hear this.
Yep.
Yes.
It's time.
Okay.
To
great.
The Right Path with Right Path Real Estate Radio with Tom Harris. Get the answer to your question that's keeping you from taking action and succeeding today. Get ready. The guide that will put your fears behind you is on the air now. Taking calls at 713-785-1817. Toll free 877-881-0271. Now here's your host, Tom
Mike Slattery.
Hey, good morning. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show, Right Path Real Estate Radio. My name is Tom Perry. I'm the host of the Right Path Real Estate Radio show. Joined live in the studio.
Oh,
can you hear me now? Hello? Can you hear me? Well,
hey, Rick.
Rick, can you hear me?
The link just went out.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. No, tell me it's not so. Well, maybe the Facebook folks, they can hear us. So we'll keep on going, even if the radio show cannot hear us. Rick, can you hear us? The link went out. I think we're having some technical difficulties at the radio show. But I want to go ahead and share with you what an amazing week that I've had. Got lots and lots of things to talk about. So I can hear Rick. I'm not sure that Rick can hear me. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Can you hear me, Rick? Can you hear me, Rick? Testing,
hey, if you're on Facebook, can you give us a thumbs up? Or on Instagram, let us know that you can hear us okay.
Yeah.
And that everything is functioning well. Is Tammy says, good morning, Daniel and Tom. Tammy, can you hear us okay?
Management or ownership of this station.
Hopefully.
It's time to get on the right path with Right Path Real Estate Radio.
Well, it sounds like there's a delay there. Maybe it's a button on their end that they can push. So I'm excited. I'm going to go ahead and talk about the things on the radio show. We were hearing everything just fine, just good. So let's see. So I'm going to say, Tammy, can you hear me? Yes. Excellent.
Yes, Tammy hears.
All right. So we're live. You can hear us now. So apparently we had a loss of signal. We're good now. We're live on the radio on AM 1110. My name is Tom Perry, host of the Right Path Real Estate Radio Show. Joined live in the studio with my brother from another mother, my good friend, my co-host, Mr. Daniel G.
Welcome back.
And yeah, thanks.
Welcome back. You know, when you spend every day with somebody.
Yes.
And then they're gone for a week.
Right.
You know, you start to, it's like, you know, start to miss people.
Yeah,
so,
absolutely. Right.
You know, come Thursday or Friday, you know.
Although I don't feel like that we were really apart.
Well, we were communicating a lot. Absolutely. Because I'll tell you what, it's like the minute you left, it was like boom, boom, boom. Deals are getting locked up. Deals are like.
I felt
so
very strongly.
A lot.
I felt very strongly that I was moving from the I quadrant, according to Robert Kiyosaki, to the B quadrant.
Yes.
That I had good people. And in fact, I told my daughter, I was like, you know what? We might do like $333,000 this week.
Yes.
In terms of gross profit.
Yes.
And I'm not bragging. I'm just saying.
Yes.
That, and I'm like, that would be a record week for us. Well, actually, we between three different companies, between Right Path, QPS, and HHB, we've had similar weeks in the past.
Sure.
But typically, it was a weekend that we were doing a weekend event.
Yes.
And then still had stuff going on in HHB and things like that. But, you know, we had a fantastic week last week. And I was out the entire week.
Yes.
So I was like, so I told my daughter, I said, hey, Chloe, we might have to do this more often.
Because
apparently things just blow up in a positive way.
Yes.
When I'm gone. So just to make an announcement, on Wednesday of this week, I'll be leaving for another 2 weeks.
Okay.
I'm just kidding.
Sounds good.
I'm totally kidding. Now, the title of this show today is, how do you respond when things go unexpectedly?
Yeah.
So the most recent thing that we can talk about is the air conditioning in the building. You got here at about 7 o'clock this morning.
A little after 7, yeah.
And you noticed, oh, wow, something's different.
Well, I noticed it in the garage.
Yeah, right.
Which I don't think they AC the garage.
Right.
The minute I got out of my Jeep in the garage, I could feel the difference in humidity.
Wow. Okay.
And I was like, something's not right.
Yeah.
And I go in the little room where the elevators are, and I'm in there, and I'm like, yeah, it's even muggy in here.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Because air conditioning people may not realize it's as much about humidity control,
yes,
as it is temperature.
So what,
right,
I'm expecting is when I step off the elevator, I'm going to hit a breath of fresh air.
Yeah,
right?
Right.
Super muggy in the elevator. I step off, and it's like...
Not a breath of fresh air.
The security guard, she's like, it's almost back on. We'll have it on in a minute.
Yeah.
So sweat through my first set of clothes.
Okay.
Kept the lights off in the office, trying to keep it a little cool.
Right.
But so went and changed about an hour.
So
we're
in the bright lights,
in.
But fortunately these lights don't. They the don't studio have any lights, heat. They don't put off heat because they're LED.
Either way, I've got my little my little forehead dabber here.
And I actually spent about 30 minutes in a really hot sauna on Saturday. Yeah. Did something similar on Thursday. We were up in Dallas, my daughter and I. We spent time. We started in San Antonio, did SeaWorld. We're going to do Fiesta Texas, but SeaWorld just kind of wore us out. So we rested all the next day.
Okay.
Stayed in a beautiful hotel, one of the few five-star hotels in all of San Antonio, right on the Riverwalk.
Nice.
You know, it was really super nice. Then transitioned up to Dallas. I joined as a Diamond Elite member of the Six Flag Parks, which gives you access to all the water parks and all the theme parks all throughout the country.
Which I believe they own the Splash Channel
do,
here in town
right.
now. That was recent.
It's called Hurricane Harbor Six Flags now.
Yep.
And so, yeah, they've rebranded and spent, God, I think they spent like $18 million on doing. They've got one of the biggest rides up there now. So we didn't go there, but we went to the Hurricane Harbor there in Dallas, and we also Arlington, stayed right across the street from the park. Did some amazing things, but so want to tell a story about preparing for my trip. So
okay.
So I decided that on Sunday, going to leave for the vacation a week ago yesterday.
Yeah.
And so I thought, you know, going to be driving a little bit, going to be spending some time in the car. You know, for everybody that doesn't know, I drive a 2012 Prius. I'm not bragging. I'm just saying.
Just saying.
And, and it's got a few miles on it, and which is fine. But I decided, hey, wouldn't it be nice to get it detailed? So I take it across. There's walking distance, a detail shop from the place where I live.
Yeah.
So I drive over there, walk back, leave it there. Car's driving fine. Go to pick it up. And it says, hybrid synergy drive failure, you know, pull over, park in a safe spot, basically saying don't drive it, right? And I'm like, oh, well, dropped it
off.
Get off
this thing before your warp drive
crashes. Driving it is fine, and I'm noticing, man, it seems really, really wet inside. I'm like, the carpets are wetter. It's like, I know they use water and all that, and there's water in the trunk. There's water, like, near the startup battery, not the synergy drive battery. I'm like... And so I drove it just a little bit, and I noticed, like, even the mirror, the remote to open up the gate or the garage door, even that wasn't working. I mean, my car was basically in failure mode.
Yeah.
And so I took it back, and I'm like, hey, pointed it out. Hey, this is what's going on. I was driving, and then immediately they wanted to start blaming, right? Like, oh, you know, it's your fault. We didn't do anything wrong. There's, you know, we only use chemicals. We don't use water. And I'm like, I'm touching the wet spots in the back of my car. And like, you know, smell here. You touch it. You smell. I mean, it smells like water to me. I don't.
Yeah.
I'm tasting it. I'm like,
doesn't taste chemically at all.
I mean, like, you know,
I feel fine.
Yeah, and they're going in there and they're blowing out with an air tube. You know, like blowing out all the water.
Yeah.
And trying to. Oh no! And one guy's like, oh, you know, one guy said he shampooed the engine, and the other guy, oh no, we don't do anything like that. I'm like, so they can't get their story straight. And now my attitude in a situation like this is, look, I'm not looking for a free anything. I'm not looking for a free car. I'm not looking for a free. But what? Hey, if I drive it in and it's not and it's working fine, and then I pick it up and it's not working, I just want to get to the bottom of it.
Yeah.
Hey, if it's my car was worn out anyway and it was about to break and it's not your fault, okay, that's one thing.
Yeah, this is just a chance happening.
Right.
Let's figure that part out.
Right, but I'd like to take it to it turns out, so I've got a mechanic that I trust, and they you know, they say that if you have a mechanic that you trust, that's one of the five, you know, people that you've got to have in your life that you trust. And so I've got one that I trust, and the guy says, hey, look, I don't necessarily have the time to get to it, but my next door neighbor is one of the service managers at Sterling McCall Toyota.
Okay.
So he said, I trust the guy. He said, if you'll have the car towed over there, he'll look at it honestly. So I told the people there, and it's like, I'm not going to drive it. I'm going to have it towed there. So now what am I going to do leaving on Monday? Well, for those of y'all that have been following, you know, my dad's been dealing with a back issue.
And
he's had back surgery. He had a disc that was herniated, and that's been taken care of. But he still had some complications. So he's been out for about 6 weeks. So he said, hey, take my car.
Great.
So didn't need to rent a car or anything like that. Drove his car. Everything's going great. So, but I'm keeping track with the guy, Rick, at Sterling McCall. And sure enough, what he said is, hey, your car has got a recall on it for a software upgrade. And so I was like, okay, that's fine. So they did that. They reset the codes. They checked out what the codes were, and they said, we can't get it to duplicate that problem. Reset the codes. Car's fine.
Okay.
So I got a chance to call the guy, and what I felt great was is on the Monday when it happened, it wasn't like, you know, you sons of guns.
You didn't flip out. You didn't disrespect anybody.
No, and I wasn't
blaming. Because you never know.
I wasn't blaming. I'm like, look, I'm not saying that you guys did anything wrong, but I'm just saying that, hey, I brought it to you guys. It was working. It's not working now. I'd like to get to the bottom of it. So, and if it's y'all's fault, I'd like you to be responsible for it, and if it's not your fault, I'm not going to ask you to do anything, yeah. Right? So I got a chance to make the phone call today to the guy, and he goes, oh, that's great news. And he goes, hey, you know, look forward to having you back. And so didn't burn a relationship. Yeah. There was no blaming or anything like that. So, you know, what I recognize is I've been around a lot of people in situations like that that don't respond that way.
Yeah.
That they immediately go in. And what I realize is that a lot of people are coming from a place of lack.
Yeah.
And it's really fear that drives all of that. So when we get into lack, we get into blaming, we get into shaming people like, this is your fault, you shouldn't have, you should have, you know, all of that. When you start saying should or shouldn't, then, you know, really what you can deal with is what you know. And what I realized in the moment, and I was really... My discipline for myself was I don't want to get in a situation where I'm making accusations without information.
Yes.
So all I went into almost like engineering, you know, information gathering mode, which my natural bent is not to be an engineer type. Now, exactly. I am a process guy, and I recognize I like systems and processes and things like that, but... What I really recognize is I'm about relationships,
yes.
And what I wanted to make sure is, hey guys, I want to make it really clear I'm not blaming you. I'm just saying that it's a coincidence. Now I'm also my undergrad degree is in psychology, and a lot of psychology is not about psychoanalyzing people or some of the things that people think psychology is about. It's really about statistics, and one of the things that there's a term in statistics called correlation. And so just because two events happen at the same time does not necessarily mean that they're related.
Exactly.
Now, sometimes they're related and sometimes they're not. And so my background in psychology basically taught me that this could be just a coincidence. But how you respond in those situations really, really matters. So going to go into a break. The music says I'm out of time. Going to open up the door and get a little bit of breeze going in if we can. So if anybody's coming to work to the office today, make sure that you dress appropriately.
Accordingly.
Yeah, so we'll be right back.
Real estate investors, do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking Meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes, binders, and the agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need
it. Hey, Rick, did you figure out what happened on the start of the show?
Leading real estate risk management experts. Benchmark Insurance
Group. Yeah, that was on your end.
Oh, it was?
569-4353.
Yeah, that Comrex lights went out just like they did before the show.
BenchmarkBroker.com.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly
I could,
general
I could hear you wrestling around with connectors
property?
And stuff. And
then call Fast Track Remodeling
at
832-742-9992.
All right.
Or reach us on the web at FastTrackRemodeling.com.
Hey, good morning, Tammy. Good morning, Ashley. Good morning, Bonnie.
Single family investment.
Good morning, Nora. Good morning, Robin. Good morning, Andy.
From start to finish,
I hope everybody is wonderful today.
Process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done. Train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right. And complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself. No more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today.
10 seconds.
832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992. Or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mic's on.
Hey, welcome back. Welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio. Our phone number, if you want to give us a call, if you want to ask any kind of questions, 713-785-1817. So this morning, I got up at like 6.
Okay.
And so not my normal wake-up time.
Yeah.
Because I'm normally like a 7:30 a.m. kind of guy.
Yeah.
And get up about 7:30, hop on the Bowflex Max Trainer, fix my shake, hop in the shower, come here. You know, my day normally starts... You know, it doesn't have to start at the crack of dawn.
No, and, 9 o'clock is your first appointment, right?
9 o'clock right here. I normally roll into the studio about 8:45, 8:50, something like, you know, which is a rock solid, 21 minutes before the show starts? So
Sometimes 9:02.
9:02, never been that late. Well, maybe that one.
Maybe once.
Yeah, but actually drove, so since I was using my dad's car over the weekend, and my car was still at Sterling McCall, we got in last night, Sterling McCall was closed, my dad said, hey, my inspection sticker's out, and it's the registration sticker's out, but I got to get it inspected, so would you drop it off at my mechanic, happens to be like Derry Ashford and Westheimer, not too far, so I drove the car over there, took an Uber from... And then had a chance to listen to a radio show at 7 a.m. that comes on the same station at 7. I don't typically, because I'm not normally up at that hour, I don't normally listen. And they great content this morning.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's interesting because Jason was talking a little bit about, you know, putting together beds for their Airbnbs.
Yeah.
And I thought, man, I just don't envy that, you know.
Yeah.
At one point in time, one of my brothers was a piano mover, like a professional piano mover.
Who wants to do that?
Yeah. I mean, my hat's off to him.
Yeah.
Talk about some hard work. When every load is going to be heavy, and you know it, it's just...
Well, it's not only that, but pianos aren't... heavy is one thing if it's shaped right.
Right, yeah.
Right?
No piano shaped right.
There's nothing easy to move about a piano.
No, and they can be fragile,
yes,
right?
I mean, so they weigh a ton, they're fragile, and they're very oddly shaped.
Right, yeah. So, they don't fit in most doorways, most elevators.
Yeah, that's the trifecta of I don't want to move that.
Right. Yeah, so next on that list would be mattresses for me. And so one of the things that we teach a lot is, you know, there's certain things that I find that entrepreneurs do that they really shouldn't be doing, like mowing their own yard or painting their own houses, things like that. However, the exception to that is when you're putting together a system or a process for the first time. Now, when I started Fast Track, you know, I didn't know anything about laying tile. And I have to say, I didn't recognize, I didn't ever feel like I needed to lay tile to understand what laying the tile would be like. Because I knew that I could hire people that already laid tile.
Correct.
But there were some things that, like, there was a process. I actually had to work with Home Depot to learn what were the ins and outs of their processes, because I recognized that we weren't getting all the discounts because they weren't very good at training their employees.
Yes.
Now, I could have gotten frustrated with that, but I actually had to get my hands dirty a little bit.
And to build the system.
And to build the system. And so, you know, I want people to take, you know, the understanding that, you know, sometimes you have to assemble a bed to be able to put together the systems and processes to know. Because it's not like a tile guy. You know, you meet with two or three tile guys, and you figure out pretty quickly how quickly they can do, like, 100 square feet of tile.
You can get an average of numbers on a tile guy because that's a profession that's already been perfected.
Correct.
Right? I don't know anybody you can call and say, hey, how long does it take to put together a bed?
Correct.
There's not professional bed putting together people.
Right.
So you would have to test it out yourself to know what you can expect from somebody else of, you know, somewhat competence.
Correct.
How long is it going to take them to put together a bed? Now, if it took me on my first try 3 hours,
right,
but they've done 10 of them for me now and it still takes them 6.
Yeah, right.
There might be an issue with the person, not the process.
Correct. And so when you understand, so it's like, hey, what are the tools they're going to need? So you can equip and train your people, because obviously you're not going to want to do that all the time. And so one of the things that I really like is I know that they're doing a training on Airbnb and all of that. And what I like is they're actually systematically working through the process to figure it out. Now, jury's still out. I mean, they're convinced it's going to work. I hope for their sake that it's going to. I mean, and I know it's working for Robert in New Jersey, for example. And I hope it goes like gangbusters. I mean, I wish them all the success in the world, and think that they will be successful. If it is figure outable, If that's a war, if that's a term or a phrase, maybe I just invented one. If it's capable of being figured out, these are the guys that I think they can figure it out. Now, I'm not convinced that it's going to work yet. So yeah. I rarely want to be that pioneer. Hats off for them for being the pioneers in this situation.
Yeah. And if they figure it out, hey, let's take a class.
I'll double the tuition cost, let's take right? Class. Yeah, absolutely. And so certainly wish them the best and think that they're going about it the right way and think that they're going to figure out the systems and the processes and all of that if it's doable. So, so then that's brings up so then. While I was listening, took the Uber, and sure enough, the Uber guy, I mean, he's from Africa, super, super sharp guy, and he's like, I've been wanting to figure out real estate, and he's like, what's this radio show about that you're listening to? And I said, well, it's about real estate investing, and then I said, hey, if you want to tune in at 11 o'clock, excuse me, at 9 a.m., if you want to tune in at 9, I'm doing a radio, there's another one at 11, not as, I don't recommend that one, I do recommend the 7 a.m. show, yes. Recommend our show, the 11 a.m., So I said, hey, if you want to tune in and listen, we talk about the deals that we're actually doing. And I told him about one of the deals that we're doing up on the north side of town. Don't want to give that away until on Friday, after we close on it Friday.
Okay, so we can give a teaser.
Yeah.
This is going to be, I think, the biggest single...
Wholesale deal. A hotel deal, really.
Hotel deal, either way.
Yeah, because
I've ever personally heard of.
Yeah.
Not that I've ever personally done.
Yeah.
That I've ever personally heard of. I know I'm sure there's bigger out there somewhere, especially in some of the other states where the...
Or even, I've heard of some in wholesaling multifamily that have been... Okay. But in terms of for the purchase dollar amount versus the sales amount, I know that I've never done one larger.
Yes.
And then we'll be able to talk about the details because... there's an owner finance play involved, yes. And then what we're going to do is I'm not an expert in selling notes.
Yeah.
But I called somebody over the weekend and said, hey, who would you sell a note to like this? And I'd already thought of one or two people right off the bat, and then I already knew how to calculate. Hey, if it's a 7% note, but a person wants to get a 10% return, how do you discount that rate? I mean, all that's easy math. I mean, that's easy calculations. And what we'll do is next week after the deal is done, we can talk about some of the math. I know that'll make for some riveting radio. Yeah.
Everybody's gonna be super stoked about that.
Although if for some people math is a struggle.
Yes.
And when you, what I would recommend is we'll make the announcement the day before the show, and I want everybody to download the mortgage calculator that I use is called Carl's Mortgage Calculator. And so really, it's one change of one variable. And, when you look at what are the variables that you can have in a mortgage, interest rate is a variable, monthly payment is a variable, principal amount, the length of time is a variable. And so normally if you have three of those, you can always solve for the fourth, right? So really it's just a matter of you put in three of those and you solve for the fourth, and then that gets monthly payment. And then you can say, okay, if I change the interest rate, what does that change the principal amount to? You've already solved for it. Yeah. So that tells everybody, which is really something simple. And then there's also a distinction. A lot of times we deal with private money lenders.
Yes.
And so they're getting interest only, and I don't know that most private money lenders know how to calculate tying up money for 7 years, for example. Like I'm doing a 7-year note at 7% on a couple hundred thousand bucks. And so for a lot of people, I've heard from some people that are just used to lending. Well, I don't want to tie up my money for that long. And one of the things that they may not realize is they're used to lending maybe at 7% for a 7-year period of time where they're only getting interest and they're leaving all of their capital. So let's say it's $400,000.
Yeah.
They're leaving all of the capital. That whole $400,000 is tied up for that entire 7 years.
Yeah.
They don't see any of that $400,000, but in an amortized note, it's completely different because you're getting interest and principal.
So you still get the same amount of interest on the deal that you would. Well, I guess you would get less.
You get a little bit less.
7% on the full amount. So you get a little bit less interest, but you start recouping your money to re-lend out a lot faster.
That's correct, right.
So you can actually take that even higher.
Yes.
If you were to work them both out all the way to the end, because you can re-lend the money.
That's right.
Not just the principal that you're getting back, but you can start lending the interest that you're getting back right away.
Correct, yeah. Yeah, in fact, I mean, you in this particular situation, you'd be getting about almost $50,000 a year back.
Yeah.
Because, and so, anyhow. So And that's between principal and interest. So for folks that, you know, like 7% rates of return, if they want to learn more about note buying or things like that, we can run through the numbers. Email support at rightpathrealestate.com. It's not a solicitation for an investor or anything like that, but this is an asset that's for sale. If someone's interested in buying an asset. So I'm not seeking investors or anything like that, but if someone is seeking to buy an asset, I do have an asset for sale, a 7% note at for 7 years.
Yeah.
And it's not interest only. It's fully amortized. Huge down payment, all that kind of stuff. So that's the other thing. And so I talked to one of my good friends, Mark Inyer. You know Mark.
Yeah.
And great guy. And it's always fascinating to see the relationships that you build over time. Here's a guy that I feel blessed to have him. He has told me to my face that, and also over the phone many times. He said, "Hey, look, I don't think I'd be where I am today if it wasn't for you. You shifted my thinking, and where he is today is amazing."
Yeah.
He had a 7-figure year, and not airing out his laundry or anything like that. But he killed it last year. I mean, nice. He's been doing fantastic. I love the guy. He's absolutely fantastic. And so, you know, when you build relationships with people like that, and I consider him a note expert. He's done a lot of notes. Absolutely. He's done a lot of seller financing, things like that. He's bought and sold notes, those kind of things. And so he was my go-to guy. I mean, like, who's in your list of experts? Yeah. And I consider him. And so I texted him, like, hey, I was on vacation last week, and I didn't want to call and interrupt. So I texted him, like, hey, you know, can you give me a call if you've got a second? I got a couple of questions. Well, he's vacationing in Yosemite National Park.
Which probably didn't suck.
He's out there with Will Dinker. I mean, one of the greatest wholesalers of all time.
Yeah,
another guy that is just absolutely amazing. And
just quick side note.
Yeah.
Like, not just amazing at wholesaling because of that skill set, but an amazing person.
Oh, absolutely. Unbelievable.
Like,
yeah.
I'll tell the story another day, but completely went out of his way to do something for me when I didn't even know him.
Yeah, right.
And it was just, it completely knocked me off my rockers.
Right.
Like, what a guy.
And there's story after story after story of that guy.
Yeah.
And, you know, again, he's a guy that originally taught me wholesaling.
Wow.
And we did a trade. It's like, hey, I'll teach you more about business because you need some serious business help. And if you'll teach me about wholesaling, we did a barter exchange.
Yeah.
And so he was the first guy to ever teach me about this is how a wholesale deal is structured.
Wow.
I mean, very, very early days. And it's funny because the first time I went in to walk into his office, he wasn't there yet, and I met some of his people like, hey, what do you do? And what do you do? And some of his people didn't know what they did. And I'm like, okay, we got to fix that. First off, people need to know what you do.
I'm just here in case something needs to be done.
And then the other thing is he spent a good half a day putting together his Apple computer and setting it up and all. I'm like, dude, are you attentive at that?
There's got to be somebody better.
Yeah.
Now, I'll be honest. I have trouble answering that question as well.
Yeah.
But it's on the opposite end of the spectrum because it's like, which one do I say?
Right, like, yeah. Well, because... Yeah, it's my dad is famous for saying, "What do you need done?"
Yeah,
because
what do you do?
What do you need done?
It's Tuesday. Let's
see. Right. Hey, you're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. The music says we're out of time. We'll be right back in just a few minutes. Stay with us.
Real estate investors, do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking Meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders? The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? Bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money. Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties. Contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you what we can do for you at 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992.
Hey, good morning, Haley. Good morning, Michael Bailey. Good morning, Juan. Good morning, Maribel. Good morning, Coletta.
FastTrackRemodeling.com.
Hope everybody had an awesome 4th of July weekend and is having a great start to their 3rd quarter.
Single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself, no more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992, or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mic's on.
There it is.
Gotta wait for the cowbell.
Gotta wait for the cowbell.
You can't listen to that show and talk before the cowbell. You gotta always wait for the cowbell. All right, so you're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. My name is Tom Perry. I'm the host of the Right Path Real Estate Radio Show. I'm joined live in the studio with my brother from another mother, my good friend, my co-host, Mr. Daniel G.
Always happy to be here.
Absolutely.
Always happy to be here.
So, so did the Six Flags in Hurricane Harbor and SeaWorld, and got a chance to see San Antonio and Arlington and a little bit of Dallas.
We've got a great area. Within or 4 hours, there is so much going on.
Absolutely.
That you don't really ever have to leave this state if you don't want to.
Nope.
Right? I mean,
unless you want to go gambling.
If you want to go gambling. Yeah. I was actually having a conversation about that over the weekend with my brother because he came down to join us Friday evening.
Sure. But actually, you could gamble here in the state just by Bitcoin.
By Bitcoin. We actually talked a little bit about that too because he was asking me a lot of questions. Yeah. I was like, I explained all the
same as
nuances of it, yeah.
Same as roulette.
But we were talking about, hey, you know, people, why aren't more people pushing for gambling in Texas? I said, you got to realize there's as many people pushing against it as there are for it. Well, who would push against it? I said, well, you know, we are, you know, this is a Baptist area for one. And then wouldn't you think that Louisiana would have people here lobbying against?
Oh, yeah, of course.
And he said, well, why would they do that?
Yeah.
I said, well, because the minute we pass it, they lose.
Yeah, right.
They're done because 90% of the people that are driving to Lake Charles are coming from the Houston area.
Sure, right.
So the minute that cuts off, I mean, that's going to kill. You know, it's just like, you know, the states that have legalized marijuana are keeping their fingers crossed that the federal doesn't say, hey, it's okay for everybody.
Sure, right. Because it's been a boom for Colorado.
Yes.
Except for unless you talk to the people from Denver, for example. I mean, it's brought in.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of elements that they don't want.
Michigan just, like, they were getting ready to file bankruptcy or legalize.
Yeah.
And they just legalized, I think, last Thursday.
Yep.
So they're expecting that to save their state. And I'm like, I don't know that that's going to work. Colorado's got some other things going on for it, too.
Yeah, right.
Like, I don't care how high you are.
Let's go and fix Detroit's winter.
I don't care how high you are. You want to be in Detroit. Yeah. I'm sorry, I shouldn't say things like that.
Right. Yeah, because we have a gal that works with us, right?
Yes.
And I won't say work for us. She, I mean, nobody works for us, but everybody works with us.
Isn't
right?
it great?
Yeah.
I love being a part of a team, man.
Yeah, it is.
I really do. Yeah. And she's awesome. I mean, we can't get her to stop saying pop, but she does great things.
Yeah. Well, it is, although, you know, I'm one of my my best friends from high school. We grew up diagonally across the street from each other, and he was from Michigan.
Yeah,
and he grew up in Midland.
Okay,
and his dad actually was born and raised in Midland, and then went to Michigan State.
Okay,
and played basketball for Michigan State.
Oh, wow.
And then went to work for Dow Chemical straight after, you know, college, and worked there till he retired. I mean,
wow.
And so at one point in time, he was stationed here in Houston, was in charge of all of customer service for Dow nationwide, fixed their national customer service system and all that, and amazing guy, and you know they were huge into basketball and all that kind of stuff, and he's like, well, you're making fun of me saying pop, But you say, hey, do you want a Coke?
Yes.
And then you go, yeah, well, what kind do you want? Oh, give me a Dr. Pepper. And that's not even a Coke
product.
That
makes sense.
Oh, give me a Sprite or give me a root beer.
So speaking about the guys on the morning show, Robert actually did a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
He did a full show on things like that in Texas, and that was one of them.
Yeah.
Right? It's like,
you want a Coke? Yeah. What kind do you want?
Give me a Sprite.
Right.
Like, what?
Right.
It's not even a cola.
Yeah, exactly. So anyhow. So
true story.
We're talking about how do you respond when things go unexpectedly?
So for me, a lot of that, the first thing that comes to mind is, you know, because I come from a restaurant service background,
yes.
right?
Mm-hmm.
And you've got so many people that will go into even, and you think that in high-end places it doesn't happen.
Oh, gosh,
but
even more so.
It's equal opportunity,
right.
even with the people that have money.
Yeah.
They'll try to come up with reasons to complain about something to get something for free.
Right, sure.
And that is for so, I think that's almost ruined the communication between customer and restaurant.
Right.
Because restaurant automatically assumes that's what's going on.
Right.
When somebody does complain, and then people that do have legitimate complaints and aren't looking for something free are afraid to even say anything because they don't want to be thought of
right.
as that person.
Sure.
So I'm the kind of guy, I like to, whether I have a good experience or a bad experience, if it's an middle ground, I typically don't even have a conversation. But if I have a really good experience, I always say, hey, is there a manager here?
Yeah.
And the server's like,
what's wrong?
Hey, can I talk to him? Is there anything I can help you with? No, I'd really like to talk to the manager. I like to give him a little bit of Shakespeare care, right? And then the manager come over. I'm like, look, I'm going to tell you, we have had the most amazing time.
Yeah.
The food was good, but the service was even better. And, you know, because nobody does that, right?
Right, right.
So then the server will come back over like, okay, you had me really worried there, you know, that kind of thing. But even when things go wrong,
right?
I always open up with, look, I don't want you to, matter of fact, let me pay my bill first.
Yeah.
Because even when you tell them no, they want to go and they want
right.
to, that's how they fix the problem.
Yeah,
oh,
sure.
It's free, free, free.
Right.
Like, look, I'm addressing this so the next person that comes and sits in my seat doesn't have to go through
right.
it.
Sure.
You should be grateful for that.
Right.
I don't want anything from you because for me, the minute I accept something free,
right.
you automatically discredit my complaint.
Yes.
So it's, how do you react when things don't go as expected? And a lot of people will try to get something done for free, or and once they start to do that, then I wonder if your mindset causes you to look for things that could go wrong.
Yep.
Just because you know, hey, this is going to be a solution.
Right.
Right. Are you looking for things that could go wrong?
Yeah.
Just so you can get something for free.
Yeah.
Whether it's at a car detail place, at a restaurant, anywhere there's service involved.
Right.
People will automatically default to that because it's a win for them.
Right. Well, I got a chance to, because I was away from home for more than a week, got a chance to receive service from a lot of different types of businesses, a lot of different, from the auto repair place to Six Flags to different restaurants to different hotels, hotels in San Antonio, restaurants on the Riverwalk, at all different levels of experience. And even coming home last night, my daughter and I, we decided to go over to City Center.
Yeah.
And we had dinner at a restaurant over there.
Okay.
And, pulled in. And I guess last time I'd eaten there was maybe 2 weeks ago, something like that.
Okay.
And they've got really good healthy food choices.
Okay.
They are very vegan and gluten friendly and all those kind of things. And so, but even on the non side of that, menu, that they have just some great food choices, right? So order, my daughter and I, we go and sit down. And it's one of these, you order at a counter. And they give you one of those little pucks so they can come and find you. And normally food's out in about 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And I think 10 minutes is a reasonable amount of time.
Absolutely.
So then it's also like they hand you a cup but you can also get beer or wine, things like that. So not going to name the name of the place or anything like that. So give me my cup. And I'm a tea drinker, and I like different flavored teas and things. I like the green teas with hibiscus or pomegranate, whatever.
Absolutely.
I like I like unsweetened teas though,
yes.
right? So what was interesting is I go get my ice, and I like a lot of ice in my iced tea. Iced is the first word in
it
iced
is.
Tea.
It comes before the tea.
Yep. So
it's okay to have more ice than tea.
I love like full glass of ice, put the tea in it, right?
Sounds really good right about now.
Okay, so I go to, and it's empty. And there's like three different flavors, and the only one that I didn't want was caffeinated. There's two decaf and then a caffeinated. Both of the decafs were empty. Now, in and of itself, that's... Here's the question. Being involved in a restaurant, should it be the customer telling the restaurant, hey, you're out of this, or should they have a system or process?
There should be a system or process, without a doubt.
Right. And so, what was interesting to me was that 2 weeks prior, then Same thing happened. Went to go get tea, and they were empty.
So they very clearly do not have a system.
So I said something to the manager, and I said, "Hey, look, just want to let you know that y'all are out of tea. Oh, we'll get some right out." Well, here's the other thing: is that they only have like one container.
So they got to make 4 gallons for you to get one cup.
Right.
That's the problem.
And I was thinking, why wouldn't they be making the other 4 gallons and have another little container so they can bring a full one out?
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, so now I'm solving their management issues.
Yes.
And I can't imagine that's a problem at every scene. To me, it's like, have you ever known of a McDonald's to run out of buns? I mean, to me, like, there's certain things it's inexcusable, right?
Yeah.
Or a Chick-fil-A to run out of chicken.
Yeah.
I mean, just certain things you shouldn't have happen. When I come, I don't see it as a complaint. I'm there to inform, and it's almost like the manager in me, the entrepreneur in me, wants it to be right so that they can have a great business.
Yes.
Because I like going there. It's convenient. I like their food. I want them to stay in business.
Yeah.
I'll keep the relationship open and continue to go there because I like those things about it.
Yeah.
And I want to share that information out of the spirit of, hey, I want y'all to fix it because not everybody's like me.
Most people will keep their mouth shut and just not go back.
Correct.
Yeah.
And so I know that it embarrasses my daughter, for example, when I speak up. She goes, "Why do you have to say something?" I said, "Well, because I want them to stay in business."
Yeah.
And I know the restaurant business
is very competitive. At the end of the day, it's a selfish reason, right?
It is.
I want to still be able to come here and enjoy myself. And if they don't get it right, they're going to end up losing customers. And the customers are what keep them in business. And then if they go out of business, I won't be able to come here.
Yeah. So then the second thing that happened there is that we ordered the meal, and it should have been out in about 10 minutes, and it took about 30 minutes.
Oh, wow.
And they weren't especially busy.
Yeah.
And so then we get finished eating, and my daughter said, and I said, "Hey, you ready to go?" And she goes, "Well, what about dessert?" And I'm like, "Well, I'm not eating dessert. I mean, I'm stuffed on the salad that I had, and it was an amazing salad. I mean, pecans and watermelon, and it was just incredible." And lost my train of thought. I was thinking about the salad.
Talking about dessert?
Yeah. No.
The salad got you excited.
Salad got me excited. I could eat one of those salads for lunch today. So she said, "Well, hey, I'd like to go for dessert." And I go, "What do you want?" She goes, "Well, let's go up." And so we went back up to the counter and ordered just a simple slice of red velvet cake.
Okay.
It's layered cake.
Yeah.
And I would have thought, okay, go to the back and slice it. I mean, after waiting about 25 minutes.
2 minutes.
I went up to the front and I was like, "Hey, is something wrong here?" He goes, "Why? What do you like? I mean, I remember the puck number. I've been looking at it for so long. I'm puck number 58, right? And I'm like, about 20 something minutes ago, I ordered a piece of cake. In fact, here's the receipt, and here's the timestamp, and we can look at the time." I'm like, she goes, "Oh, well, you're up next." And I'm like, "For a piece of cake?" And what I noticed is that the manager hadn't been up. The manager serves as like the line person doing it. And I was like, wow.
Struggling.
Yeah. And again, my heart is like I don't want to explode. That's not my heart, because what I want to know is I want to respond in the appropriate way. And it's like, hey guys, y'all are and I don't blame the employees.
No.
What I realize is that's a management.
Built,
yeah, that's a management issue. When I see dirty restrooms, I don't blame the employees. I blame the managers. I went to a Subway restaurant over the weekend, and right before we were going to Six Flags, there was a Subway, and I figured, hey, I want to eat something healthy because there's probably not going to be anything healthy, and I got a vegetarian sandwich in the Subway, and I noticed that there was no tea. They were completely out of tea, and they said, "Well, look, our truck arrived late. It just got here just a few minutes ago, and there was no water. Like, there was no bottled water in the refrigerator." I'm like, "How do you run?" And then I go to wash my hands in the bathroom. There's no soap in the dispenser, and I'm like, "Okay, so." But I noticed that the manager and about three or four of the employees were yakking about all the personal politics and things like that. So, you're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio, and I'll tell about how I handled that situation.
You know, you think getting a simple piece of cake out would be
a piece of cake.
We'll be right back.
Time is money in a real estate deal.
Wow, right.
If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal.
In this temperature, that got really thick.
You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders. The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money.
Nice.
Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties. Contact Benchmark for our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you what we can do for you at 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Hello, real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Was there somebody there?
1 minute.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself, no more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mic's on.
Hey, welcome back. Welcome back, Right Path Real Estate Radio. We didn't talk a whole lot of real estate this morning, and that's okay because we're talking about how to respond, because it's not always about, you know, any of these principles we can talk about in terms of your business.
So I think it's important to know that how you respond when things don't go as expected is something that you are going to have to develop either a positive reaction for, or know that you're going to be dealing with a lot of negative. Because,
well, are you building relationships in the way that you approach it? So for example, I mean, I said, hey, who's the manager? And she goes, I'm the manager. And I said, hey, just let you know that there's no soap in the men's room. And she goes, oh, well, I'll fix that right away. So she goes out, and she goes in the men's room, and I go in there also because I'm wanting to wash my hands, right? And I said, oh, by the way, also want to let you know that, you know, as a customer, and I'm a patron of Subway, like the franchise, you know, all of that. And this is a great location, you know, right across from Six Flags, all that, very convenient. And it looked like a former like pizza place, like one of those like Shakey's pizza. Or, I mean, old school, you know. And we'd never seen a Subway quite like that. It was really, really nice. And said, hey, just feedback. When as a customer, and I own my own business, so I want feedback like this. But you know, seeing all of you kind of congregated around, kind of talking shop, and you know, anybody can listen. It'd be different if you were back in the back, but you're right up front by the cash register. And there's like two people working the line, and there's like four other employees that aren't working.
Yes.
It's very clear. And I said, y'all are out of water, and y'all are out of tea. And I don't drink soft drinks. I want to stay relatively healthy. And so no one's working on that, but everybody's working on talking about the politics. And of the shop, like, and it's all, you know, employee drama, and this, you can't believe what this person said, and then like, so it's like, if you have time to do that, but you don't have time, then just understand how that makes a customer feel. And again, I'm saying this so that y'all work on it, so that you fix it, not because I'm complaining that I want anything for free or anything like that. She goes, you know what, I honestly, you bring up some really, really good points. And she said, thanks for sharing that. And next thing you knew, and things were getting done. Yeah. And you realize, hey, sometimes it's people just get in a rut of not doing the right things for the right reasons. And it's like, and she goes, and what, some of the things that she said is like, you kind of get, she goes, well, I'm not even working today. I'm like, well, if you're not working, what are you doing here? It's like, because as a customer, I don't know and I don't care.
Here's what I can tell you as a manager. You're responsible for it whether you're working or not.
Right.
Because you're the one that develops the culture in that store, the system, the processes, and all that sort of things.
Yes.
And I think a lot of times, especially when it's in a good location,
right,
like that one obviously is.
Right, yeah, of course.
They can let some other stuff go, and it doesn't affect their business as much as it would if they were in a spot that didn't get that much traffic.
That's correct.
So they've probably gotten in a habit of overlooking some of those things.
And I recognize that retail is tough. I mean, it is.
Absolutely.
And in the restaurant business, is tough as well, and so thank goodness we're not in that. And I even talked, you know, with the Uber driver today. I mean, it's like you really recognize people can bring excellence with them wherever they go, and excellence pays dividends for the long term. So, are you waking up in the morning and are you doing things with excellence?
Yes.
And are you bringing an attitude where you build relationships, where you foster relationships, and because that pays dividends as well. You never know when you're going to need to have that person in your life. So I feel like, you know, in the last week, I built a relationship with a person that detailed my car. I've furthered the relationship with Mark Inyart, and then built a relationship with a service guy. You can leverage relationships you have, and they share their relationships because you built it. So the guy that fixed my car leveraged his next door neighbor relationship with somebody else at Sterling McCall, and you realize, hey, when you're doing things, the right things for the right reasons for a long enough period of time, it just success builds a habit.
Absolutely.
And habits, those are the kind of habits that you want to continue to reinforce. And so it was great to spend this last week with my daughter. I'm not going to see her for the next, tomorrow and Wednesday she'll be in Galveston.
So then I
get her back Wednesday evening, and we're going to spend a lot of time together this weekend and that kind of stuff. So looking forward to more adventures.
Yeah.
And then we'll talk a lot more about real estate tomorrow.
We've got a few deals to talk about.
Oh, my gosh.
Sure.
We've got some incredible deals. And, dude, we've got a big closing today where we're just up acting as an agent on a commercial deal, and we'll share some of those numbers tomorrow. And especially I want wholesalers to be able to tune in tomorrow to recognize that I bet we're making more in commission on a commercial real estate deal when we're the agents than what most wholesalers will make in a year.
Absolutely.
So if you want to learn more about that in 20 seconds. And that's all driven by your goals.
It is.
And really that's one of the messages here at Right Path is, where are you trying to get to? And if it's someplace other than where you are right now, that's not a destination. Decide where you're trying to get to. And if you need help with that, email support@rightpathrealestate.com. We love you guys. We want to help you be successful. So thanks so much. We'll see you tomorrow.
We'll see you soon.
You've been listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. Find Tom at rightpathrealestate.com. You can put the fear behind you and listen every day from 9 to 10 a.m. on Business 1110 KTEK.